Watch this, Irfan Khan masterpieces to understand his brilliance. He was the ultimate character actor. With his bulging eyes and deep intellect, Irfan Khan, who died this week at the age of 53, was versatile, sought after, and equally adept in the role of hero, villain, or the truth of somewhere in between. He was the rare Indian character who found success in both Bollywood and Hollywood. I interviewed him in 2010 and he explained why he liked working in the US despite earning significantly less here. America, he told me, allows me to push my boundaries as an actor. Here are some of those roles. Piku, 2015. In this heartwarming comedy of a father-daughter relationship with plenty of bathroom humor, Khan plays a taxi driver with family drama of his own. It's a classic Khan sidekick role, as his wisdom ends up carrying much of the film's message. The Lunchbox, 2013. This is about as perfect a movie as it gets. Khan plays Sajan Fernandez, an everyman accountant who has just been widowed. He accidentally starts to receive lunches with notes in them made by a woman trying to save her own marriage, and a virtual affair begins and blossoms. The Namesake, 2016. It's one of those rare cases where the movie might be better than the book. And that's all because of Irfan Khan. He plays Ashok Ganguly, an Indian immigrant in America, grappling with a new land, a new wife, and big dreams. The scenes between him and Tabu, who plays his wife, are sweet and memorable, holding universal lessons about how true love might actually come after marriage. In Treatment, 2010, this is the only TV series I'm including, but the intensity and simplicity of a show about a psychotherapist and his clients plays to Khan's strengths. Khan plays Sunil, who leaves India after his wife's death to move in with his son and daughter-in-law in Brooklyn. It happens to be the reason I interviewed Khan, and he told me then. There's a uniqueness to this program. I can't say it's cinema or television or the theater. This camera of director doesn't take liberties with time and space. Life of P, 2012. In director Ann Lee's adaptation of a boy's remarkable survival at sea, Khan plays the adult character of Piscin P. Patel. A scene from his movie where P talks about life and death is now being widely shared. I suppose in the end, the whole of life becomes an act of letting go, but what always hurts the most is not taking a moment to say goodbye indeed. Slumdog Millionaire, 2008. This movie unfurls in a series of poignant flashbacks, and Khan plays the police inspector who keeps bringing us back to the modern day. The transformation from tough talking and threatening to forgiving and compassionate is signature. Khan and this film introduced him to Western audiences in a big way. Life in a Metro, 2007. Khan's life and career span a rapidly changing and modernizing India. This film captures the angst among India's young and restless professional class looking for love and meaning. Khan plays Monty, a sweet but socially awkward guy, again one we all know. Like PQ, this movie showcases Khan's comedic timing. Hindi Medium, 2017. My friend and film critic Asim Chopra wrote a biography on Khan released earlier this year and highly recommends this movie. The film is about getting kids' admissions to elite schools, and Khan is reported to be hilarious. Haider, 2012. This is the third installment of director Vishal Bhardwaj's Shakespearean trilogy. Khan also acted in the highly acclaimed Makbul. In Haider, Khan emboldens the protagonist's desire for revenge over his father's death, and the film brilliantly underscores how politics become so personal and family division in times of militancy. What strikes me in the above roles is how Often Khan played someone we all know and mastered the art of turning this ordinary moment into the extraordinary lesson. In announcing his cancer diagnosis 2 years ago, he quoted Margaret Mitchell saying, "Life is under no obligation to give us what we expect," he placed. "To those who waited for my words, I hope to be back with more stories to tell. Those rules and those stories endure." New script from BBC, written by S. Mitra Kalita. Please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.